السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولًا سديدًا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. All praises due to Allah. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His help and forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our own souls and that of our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides will never go astray, and whomsoever is led astray, no one can guide. I bear witness, I testify openly that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything He has given us today. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us the ability to come to the masjid to pray Salat al-Jum'ah and to be included in this description where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called upon the true believers, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. So you are all believers, alhamdulillah, because you responded positively to the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you left everything behind. All of the worldly affairs should be left by the door. Once we step into the masjid, we are here to remember Allah and to learn and to get to know more about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also to reflect on our behavior. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to understand and to practice. Allahumma ameen. Alhamdulillahi awwalan wa akhira. Masha'Allah. أرى اليوم كثيرا من الشباب فالحمد لله على هذه النعمة ونسأل المولى سبحانه أن يجعل هذا المسجد عامرا بالشباب وبالصغار وبالكبار وأن يرزقنا وإياكم خدمة بيته على الوجه الذي يرضيه اللهم تقبل يا رب العالمين. الحمد لله, I could see a fair number of youth today and some kids. الحمد لله. That's why I find myself rushed directly to one of the most important characters in the history of life, who is Luqman. And when I say one of the most important characters in the life, because you could see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified a whole chapter in Quran for Luqman. A whole chapter in Luqman in Quran was named after Luqman, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned some of the advice he had given to his son and actually to each and every one of us. قال الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد آتينا لقمان الحكمة أن اشكر لله. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given Luqman, this righteous man, the wisdom, so that he should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by the way, Luqman is not a prophet. He was a righteous man. Some scholars tried to check this point because they were, you know, overwhelmed by this point. Why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this man in this Quran, that we recite these verses till the day of judgment? There should be a wisdom behind this, and there should be a reason for this. And this is what we are going to elaborate in these few minutes, inshallah. قيل للقمان الحكيم كما يروي مالك في موطئه ما بلغ بك ما نرى, يعني من الفضل, يعني كيف وصلت إلى هذه المرحلة. قال بثلاث أمور: صدق الحديث وأداء الأمانة وترك ما لا يعنيه. كلمات موجزة لكنها في الحقيقة منهاج حياة. لو تمسكنا جميعا بهذه الثلاثة الأخلاق وبهذه الثلاثة الصفات, والله نفلح في حياتنا بعون المولى سبحانه وتعالى. This righteous man Luqman, and he was at the time of the prophet Dawood alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a lot of wisdom and a lot of blessings, that every word he's saying is a wisdom and is a great advice. One day he was asked, what has brought you to what we see? They mean, how did you get to this high rank and this high level of understanding and of this wisdom? He said, I actually practice three qualities in my life. Number one is truthful speech. And number two is صدق الحديث وأداء الأمانة, fulfilling the trust. And number three is I leave what does not concern me. And all of these characteristics, all of these qualities, actually we are required to apply in our religion and in our day-to-day life. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually made it obvious in many ahadith that being truthful and being fulfilling the trust and leaving what does not concern you is a great sign of iman, of a true faith. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أردنا أن نأخذ هذه الثلاثة نبدأ بها كلامنا وإلا فالكلام عن لقمان يطول قبل أن نصل إلى الآيات الكريمات في المصحف الشريف التي تناولت جانبا من وصايا لقمان لابنه دعونا ننظر في هذه الثلاثة الصفات لأنها من الأهمية بمكان أولا صدق الحديث Being truthful is one of the qualities that every Muslim should apply into his life. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عليكم بالصدق أمر مباشر من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم Adhere to truthfulness فإن الصدق يهدي إلى البر For truthfulness leads to good deeds وإن البر يهدي إلى الجنة And good deeds leads to paradise ولا يزال الرجل يصدق ويتحرى الصدق حتى يكتب عند الله صديقا And if a man continues to tell the truth he will be recorded as a truthful person before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala And on the other hand in the same hadith actually قال المصطفى في نفس الحديث وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَالْكَذِبِ He is warning us against telling lies. وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَالْكَذِبِ Avoid, O people, avoid falsehood. For falsehood leads to bad deeds. And bad deeds leads to the hellfire. And if a man continues to tell lies day and night every time and take it just as a joke everywhere, telling lies and telling falsehood, what is the result? He will be recorded before Allah as a liar. وَلَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَكْذِبُ وَيَتَحَرَّى الْكَذِبَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا عَفَانَ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكُمْ That's why we say that being truthful is really important. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was known as الصادق الأمين even before he gets the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال تعالى ولقد آتينا لقمان الحكمة الحكمة وقال في آية أخرى ومن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا That's why people at that time was wondering how did you get to this high rank of wisdom? How is it that every word you say is worth to be listened at, listened to? He said صدق الحديث This is number one وأداء الأمانة أمرنا المولى سبحانه وتعالى أيضا بأداء الأمانة في غير موضع من القرآن الكريم وبالوفاء بالعهد أيضا إن الله يأمركم أن تؤدوا الأمانات إلى أهلها وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم وفي إشارة إلى أن المولى سبحانه وتعالى لا يخلف الوعد أبدا حتى نتعلم أيضا أن نمتثل هذه الصفة الكريمة قال تعالى إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commanded us to always be trusted. And when we are trusted, we should fulfill this trust and never betray the trust. إِنَّ اللَّهَ Allah will never break his promise. سبحانه وتعالى. And number three, which is highly important, وَتَرْكْ مَا لَا يَعْنِينِ كُلُّنَا يَحْفَظُ حَدِيثَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنْ حُسْنِ إِسْلَامِ الْمَرْءِ تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it is from the excellence of one's faith, of one's Islam, is to leave what does not concern him. Because we've mentioned before that mistakes come from too much talking. If there is an issue, if there is a topic, if there is something happened around me that does not concern me, I better keep silent. And this is even a sign of wisdom. And it is, because when Luqman was asked, how did you get to this point, to this high rank of wisdom? He says that one of these things, I always keep silent, so long as what's happening does not concern me. We are not saying here to be negative if something happens around you, don't care. Rather, we say, If I cannot participate, if I cannot give a good word, I rather keep silent. Please, like every Friday, we ask you to get to move forward a little bit, so we allow our brother to join us. Alhamdulillah, we have a big number of people today. قدموا للأمام يرحمكم الله. ومن السنة أيضا حينما يصل المصلون الكرام إلى المسجد أن يتقدم كل فيملأ الفجوة التي بينه يعني بين المصلي وبين أخيه. بهذا لا نحتاج إن شاء الله أن نتوقف وأن نذكركم، فأنتم أهل خير وفضل. بارك الله لكم. So it's really important, inshallah, one of the, I mean, the way to be wise and to have this fiqh of Jumu'ah. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يجلس حيث انتهى به المجلس. So when you come to the masjid, try to make it to the front, so long as you find a spot, inshallah. This is even good for the communication. جزاكم الله خيرا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Luqman al-hikmah, which is the wisdom. And Luqman actually used this wisdom to advise people. And he started with his family. And this is the first lesson we get from Surah Luqman and from the advice, all of the advice that been given to the son of Luqman. That we are required to advise our children and to be always contacting with him, with them, trying to raise them up the way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah, we have passed this point of tark ma la ya'nini, to leave what does not concern me, because I truly believe that we are, alhamdulillah, all of us apply this point into our day-to-day life, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us all the wisdom. What is the first and the foremost advice that Luqman had given to his son? وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. The first advice he gave to his son is never associate partners to Allah. This is the basis. And this is the foundation of our religion, the foundation of everything. To always feel and to act accordingly, that everything we do is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And we have given this example many times, that someone cannot just collect the books of medicine trying to study and then they write the prescription after a few months. It doesn't go this way. But they should join the college, study and get the degree, and then they start to, you know, to start the work and the job, and they are at that time qualified to get the prescription. And we do the same. We cannot just say, I do the good deeds, but I don't have time to pray. Okay, when it is that people need sadaqah, I pay, alhamdulillah, but I have some problems that I can't catch up with prayer, which is every single day. So this is a big trouble. Because prayer, as-salah, is a big deal in our religion that we should pay much attention to. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the rewards for every single thing you do. But never waste your rewards by leaving the bases and just trying to, you know, to participate every once in a while. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as we mentioned in Salat al-Fajr, after Fajr, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Have this worship towards your Lord till the inevitable comes to you, till the certainty comes to you, till the death. Worshipping Allah is every minute in our life. When we inhale and exhale, every single second in our life, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Luqman al-Hakim, this wise man, this righteous man, and again, he is not a prophet, he advised his son first and foremost, maintain the oneness of Allah. So you will be in the safe side. And then he starts to give him the next advice. And towards the end of this verse, يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. It's a great wrong and a great transgression if someone associate anyone or anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And alhamdulillah, in our religion, as you know, that the gate to step into The guardians of Islam is to say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. This is the very first step. And then to act accordingly. يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. This was actually the first advice from Luqman al-Hakim, this wise man that been given the wisdom from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his being. Telling truth, fulfilling the trust, and leaving what does not concern him. نسأل الله تعالى أن يرزقنا وإياكم الحكمة فمن يؤت الحكمة فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه واجمعنا اللهم به في مستقر رحمتك ودار كرامتك يا رب العالمين. وبعد فإني أوصيكم وأذكركم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى فهي النجاة في الدنيا والآخرة وينجي الله الذين اتقوا بمفازتهم لا يمسهم السوء ولا هم يحزنون. استكمالا لكلامنا عن لقمان وعن حكمته وعن وصاياه لابنه، الحمد لله لم نتعرض إلا لوصية واحدة، وإن كان في العمر بقية إن شاء الله نستكمل معا في الجمعة القادمة وربما أيضا الجمعة التي بعدها. فالوصية الأولى يا بني لا تشرك بالله. ونريد أن نؤكد على هذه الصفات التي تحلى بها لقمان، من أجل ذلك كان بين الناس ذا هيبة وذا شأن وذا علم وذا حكمة، ألا وهي صدق الحديث وأداء الأمانة وترك ما لا يعنيني. Three simple words, three simple phrases, but still it needs too much effort to get to this point. To be watchful of every word you say, صدق الحديث, and to tell the truth all the time, it needs an effort. وأداء الأمانة, fulfilling the trust, it needs also an effort and struggle, especially in this life where, you know, a lot of nonsense is happening around you and you need to be, you know, to adhere to your principles and to your religion, it needs a lot of effort and struggle. And number three, leaving what does not concern me. If I'm able to participate and to give the advice and to give the suggestion that I am totally aware of, then go ahead and do it. Otherwise, I allow other people to do it. لذلك قال المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. We have two ways. Either to speak which good or to remain silent. And both of them actually indicates the true belief. So we stick to our religion and we always ask Allah to keep us steadfast on Iman. That's why if I am able to speak which is good, which is beneficial to people, go ahead and speak. فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا. Otherwise, أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. Or just remain silent and deep in your heart saying, Oh Allah, I'm not able to participate, but oh Allah, you know that I can't share in that thing, but I ask you to forgive me, and I'm trying to get the wisdom from people around me. لأن الحكمة ضالة المؤمن كما نقول. No matter who is saying or who is participating, no matter who is raising the flag, but the flag should be raised and should be carried and should be still on till the day of judgment. إذن أيها الأحباب نتعلم من قصة لقمان أنه إنما أوتي الحكمة ومن يؤتى هذه الحكمة كما قال القرآن الكريم فقد أوتي خيرا كثيرا. ومن أبرز ما كان يمارسه لقمان في حياته اليومية هو الصدق والأمانة وترك ما لا يعنيه، وهذه من أعظم الصفات التي ينبغي أن يتحلى بها الأطفال والصغار والشباب والكبار، وأن نكون جميعا قدوة لأولادنا في هذا الباب. فلا يكذب الرجل في حضرة أولاده ثم ينتظر منهم أن يكونوا من الصادقين، هذا يعني يحتاج إلى مراجعة. ونسأل الله أن يهذبنا جميعا وأن يعلمنا وأن يخلقنا بأخلاق المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقبل أن نغادر وقبل أن ننهي هذه الخطبة، نذكر حضراتكم ونتقدم نيابة عن إدارة المسجد وعن نفسي المتواضعة بالشكر الجزيل لكل من ساهم في مساعدة المسجد من حيث أعمال البناء وما إلى ذلك في جمع التبرعات التي كانت منذ أيام. نسأل الله تعالى أن يخلف عليكم بالخير وأن يجعل ذلك في موازين حسناتكم، والخير ما زال متاحا، لا يغلق هذا الباب إلى أن تقوم الساعة. فالصدقة لا ترتبط بوقت ولا بمكان، فبإمكانك أيها الأخ الكريم أن تأتي إلى المسجد أيضا إن لم تتمكن من اللحاق بنا في الحدث أو في المناسبة التي تمت منذ أسبوع لجمع تبرعات لهذا المسجد المبارك، فبإمكانك أن تأتي إلى المسجد وأن تعطي ما يمن الله سبحانه وتعالى به عليك ابتغاء وجه الله، وتكون لك بحول الله تعالى وقوته صدقة جارية. الحمد لله, the door is still open for everyone who wants to donate to support the masjid. The buildings is already in process, and the masjid still needs each and every one of you. And we are so grateful that a lot of people actually showed so much generosity for the sake of Allah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you all in abundance. If you are not able even to participate, just remember this masjid and this house of Allah in your dua, that Allah keeps it always open and accessible to everyone. نسأل الله تعالى أن يجعلنا وإياكم من عمار المساجد. اللهم إنا يا رب على عمارة بيتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم تولى أمرنا وأحسن خلاصنا وردنا إليك مردا جميلا. اللهم أحسن لنا الخواتيم، اللهم أحسن خاتمتنا، اللهم أحسن خاتمتنا، اقض عنا ديننا، واشف يا رب مرضانا، وارحم موتانا، وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا شقيا ولا محروما، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.